Let's start by looking at how to connect DAXstudio to your database. Now, DAXstudio has multiple options to connect to different services. It can connect to Power Pivot, to Power BI Desktop, to Visual Studio, or to Analysis Services Tabular. It can also connect to Power BI Desktop, and you can launch it as an external tool. We will see the details of all these connections, and we will also take a look at the advanced options. The advanced option is this panel that contains features that are not always needed, but in some special cases, they are really important in order to be able to activate all the features of DAXstudio. With all that said, let's start by looking at the details. When you launch DAXstudio, the first thing that you need to do is connect it to a model. Now, you see that we basically have three options: Power Pivot, Power BI or SQL Server Data Tool models, or Tabular servers. You see that the first option, Power Pivot, is disabled. And the reason is, if you want to connect DAXstudio to the Power Pivot model inside an Excel file, you need to start DAXstudio from inside Excel. Let's see how it works. Cancel this, we close DAXstudio, and we go to Excel. I have an Excel file that contains a Power Pivot model. Under Add-ins, we have DAXstudio. If you click on it, DAXstudio will open, and now, as you see, we have the Power Pivot model enabled. The reason is that DAXstudio started from inside Excel, therefore the connection is available. It is enough to click on Connect to have DAXstudio connect to Excel, and now I have all the columns and all the information available. So I can start using DAXstudio straight from inside Excel. If you are not interested in Excel and instead you want to connect DAXstudio to other tools, then you have two other options. The first one is a Power BI or a SQL Server Data Tool model. I have two ways of connecting DAXstudio to Power BI. The first one is to use this list. DAXstudio lists all the Power BI files which are open right now on my machine. And you see that I have three different files of Power BI Desktop, and I also have a Visual Studio project open. I can just click on one of them, click on Connect, and now DAXstudio is connected with Power BI Desktop. I can also use external tools with Power BI Desktop. So instead of launching DAXstudio from here, I can start from a Power BI Desktop file like this one, and under External Tool, I have DAXstudio. Let's zoom in a bit. It is enough to click that button to open DAXstudio directly connected with this Power BI Desktop file. This is likely to be the most easy and convenient way to open an instance of DAXstudio connected with Power BI Desktop. The last feature that I have to connect DAXstudio to a model is that of using one server. That server can be either an Azure Analysis Services server or a server on my local machine. If I connect DAXstudio to an Azure server, it's going to take a bit longer to do the connection, and I also need to provide the credentials that I will use in order to activate the connection. So I just impersonate myself, and then, as you see, it takes a bit longer because it need to use the internet in order to move the connection back and forth. Once it's ready, I will have DAXstudio open and connected with my instance. Now I am connected with the Azure server, and you see that I can choose the database that I want to use, and I also can choose the perspective that I want to connect to. But again, let's save this for later. I can also use DAXstudio to connect to this local machine. So instead of using a server on the web, I can use the local machine and click on Connect. Now, before connecting to it, let's take a look at the advanced options. Under the advanced option, I have the initial catalog. Now, initial catalog is the database to which DAXstudio connects immediately. This might be needed in case you are an administrator of some models, but you are not the administrator of the instance. If that is the case, you need to provide the initial catalog in order to activate features like server timings, and query plan from inside DAXstudio. We will see the feature later, but it's good to know that you need to do that. You can use the direct query mode that is useful for older version of analysis services where you had to specify in the connection whether the query is a direct query or a vertical query. This is no longer needed with the newest version of analysis services. You have the MDX compatibility that activates a specific compatibility mode that were useful with previous version of Excel. And finally, effective username and roles. If you are an administrator of the database, you can open a connection impersonating another user or impersonating a list of specific roles. And this is extremely useful whenever you need to check a query as if it was executed by another user or under a specific role, or if you want to analyze the performance of the security model you have implemented in your model. You can also set the international settings that is again useful in order to connect to your instance using a specific international setting. And finally, you have the additional options. Under additional option, you can write additional parameters which are injected in the connection string that is sent, that is used in order to open the connection with the database. Whatever method you use, once you open DAXstudio, then you can start working with the database using the features which are available in the metadata panel. But we will talk about the metadata panel later.